Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. We basically guide the aspirants who prepare for civil services, and in this video we will be talking about our latest initiative which we have launched for the aspirants of UPSC CSE 2020. So those students, those aspirants who are preparing for 2020, they will be pleased to know that we have prepared a year-long timetable for you people, which you can follow, and by following which you can cover your syllabus in a comprehensive and streamlined way. So friends, before telling you the details, basically I would like to tell you that this is a test series based approach. That is, you will be given certain a timetable, and you will have to follow that timetable, and you will have to cover the topics according to that timetable, and there will be scheduled tests of you people on the scheduled dates. So let's see what this initiative is all about. So it is an initiative for the aspirants of UPSC CSE 2020, as I have told you earlier. So it is a year-long plan in which we will cover your entire general studies syllabus through test series based approach. So your entire syllabus of general studies will be covered by us. So how it will work, friends? So basically, friends, students will be given 12 months long timetable that is to be followed by them, and that timetable will cover the months from June 2019 to May 2020, and it will be a target based approach, and on scheduled date there will be a test of the given target, and there will be 45 full length tests of 100 questions each. So you can see that 45 tests of 100 questions each means 4500 questions. And friends, sometimes the students face the problem that there are a lot of institutes that provide you the test series, but the focus on current affairs is not that much. But the importance of current affairs is very high when we see the UPSC syllabus patron and UPSC patron of asking the questions. So for the to sort out this problem of you people, what we have planned, we will be taking your current affairs test as well at the end of the month. So for example, if we are starting from June month, then June 2019, then we will be giving you certain targets and we will be taking your certain tests, but on the last day of June month we will be taking your current affair test that will comprise question that will contain questions only from current affairs. That is, you will be getting 100 question, 100 MCQs on June month current affairs on the last day of the month. So in this way, we will cover your all the months or 12 months that will be preceding your prelims exam of UPSC CSE 2020. So the entire syllabus of general studies will be revised minimum three times in this 12 months long timetable. So entire timetable has been designed in a way that revision, at least your revision, takes place three times. So apart from these scheduled prelims oriented tests, there will be 45 mains oriented tests also, followed by MCQ based tests. So it is, this test series is not just about your prelims tests, it is also about your mains test, because friends, UPSC is a preparation, is a kind of an integrated preparation. You can't compartmentalize your preparation. You can't say, okay, first we will prepare for prelims and then we will move on to mains. Here the necessity is to follow an integrated approach, and keeping that necessity in mind, we have prepared your timetable in a way that you will be also giving 45 mains tests. So of these mains tests, we will properly evaluate your answers, mains answers. So we will not just be giving you questions, we will also be evaluating your answers. We will be providing you the tips for the answer writing. We will help you in improving your answer writing skills, because lot of students face the difficulty of writing answers in the mains, because they feel it easy to clear the prelims, but they don't know how to appear in mains, how to write in mains, how to complete this entire set of paper in a limited time frame. So all these problems of answer writing practice, of improvement, of writing a beautiful answer will be solved by us, and we will be providing you feedback also. And in addition, we will also be providing synopsis for each question. That is, we will be providing you the value addition material that you will be getting for the each question that we will be asking in our mains tests. So friends, which the question now comes, that which sources will be covered through these tests. So let me tell you friends that basically the UPSC preparation demands the coverage of NCERTs and standard books and current affairs. So our entire timetable has been designed in a way that you will be able to cover NCERTs also, that will cover your basic concepts and also your standard books that are recommended by the toppers for each component of general studies. So we will be covering all the standard books for a particular component of GS if it is important to you, and we will be also covering the economic survey part, that will be the latest, not it will not be kind of old, but it will be the latest economic survey, which is very important for your mains point of, from your mains point of view as well as prelims point of view. And apart from that, we will also cover your budget and current affairs also, and current affairs will be covered from your Da Hindu and PIB, and your UPSC previous year question papers will also be covered, because there are lot of questions that UPSC asks from its previous year papers, or in simple words, you can decipher the pattern of the UPSC by seeing its previous year papers. So if for this you don't have to do an extra effort, because this effort will be done by us for you people. We will be also asking you questions from the past year papers of UPSC, and it will cover nearly 19 years, that is from 2001 to 2019. So also committees and their reports that are important, they are also asked by the UPSC, and we will be also covering these important committees as well as their reports. Apart from this, we will be covering Niti Aayog's strategy for New India, or for that matter any of its long-term planning document which it releases or which it has released until now. So we will be covering all these, so you will not have to worry. So how this initiative will benefit you, the question is now, that is very important for you people. So friends, we would like to explain you the benefits. First of all, let me tell you friends that prelims is a stage where 5 lakh students compete for making it into the mains list. So in fact, if we say, then the prelims is that stage where the competition is the most intense, because after that the competition goes on decreasing. At the level of prelims, the competition is most intense, and this competition requires the careful crafting of the aspirant to beat this competition and to make it into the final mains list. So this test series, basically it will prepare you, it will basically help you in crafting yourself in a way that the UPSC demands, so that you can make it into the mains list or even and even into the final merit list. So the second thing is that the entire timetable is for 1 year, and it has been prepared and that you will be required to follow, and this is kind of a time bound approach. So we will be taking a time bound approach, we will not be just doing something random, and in this way you will be covering your syllabus, you will be completely occupied by your syllabus for complete 1 year. You will have no time for wastage, and you will be focusing your energy completely on the tests. And the third thing is that that the tests will cover both NCERTs and standard books, and this will ensure that you cover basic concepts along with tricky aspects of the syllabus, because we will be covering also your standard books as well as NCERTs. And also after that friends, as I have told you that we will be taking your mains tests also, and you know that 45 main tests will be taken, so we will not just be taking prelims tests. So this is what UPSC demands. It demands a synchronized and integrated approach for the preparation, and this integrated approach will be ensured by your prelims as well as mains tests. So mains tests will be of 8 questions each,
speech, and it will be given to you after the prelims test, and you will be kind of preparing for the main stage, and you will be covering your entire syllabus for the mains as well, well before the prelims exam, well before your prelims exam. So you will be at a cut above your, the other aspirants in in your preparation, because you will be preparing for the mains in advance. And also, friends, we will not just be giving you the questions, we will also be providing you the solutions. So solution, you will get the solutions for each test, whether it is prelims test or mains test. So these explanation, we will also provide detailed explanations in these for the solutions of the test. So you will not get just questions, you will get explanations, and these explanations are prepared by our experienced faculty. And these explanations will be such that you will be covering also those aspects which are unconventional but are important for your UPSC, but they are not covered in your standard or for that matter in NCERT book. So we will be also covering those unconventional aspects or topics of the syllabus, which are the kind of, we can say, emerging areas of your syllabus. So after these 5 points, I want to say simple thing to you, that once you see our timetable, you will get to know all the benefits that you will get by following our test series. And I will I would like to share the timetable with you. I will be providing the PDF also in the description box. You can download the PDF and you can see the entire timetable, but I will also show you the timetable in a broad way here also. So here is the timetable, you can see. So this is the timetable that has been prepared by us. So you can see this is test number one, and it is of NCERT history, and it will be on 12 June 2019. So it will be covering your history and history class 6th, 7th, 8th, and your UPSC past year papers, year 2001 to 2006, and then map based questions will also be there in that test, and region of that will be India. And also you will be given main self study test of 8 questions based on above topics. So here you can see test 2, it is also of NCERT history. So it will be covering the pending NCERTs, that is class 9th, class 10th, and themes in world history 12th, and selected chapters only, and also map based questions of the region of South Asia and history past year papers of 2007 to 2013. So test 3 will comprise of it is also of history, and it will cover your themes in Indian history part 1 class 12, and then part 2 also, and part 3 also, and then map based questions, and then previous past year question papers of UPSC from year 2014 to 2019, apart from your main self-study test of 8 questions based on above topics. And then comes your test 4. As I had told you, that there will be a current affair test at the end of the every month. Then obviously 30 June is the end of the month. So on 30 June 2019, there will be current affair test that will be covering your current affairs of June month, as well as of PIB and Da Hindu. And you will also be getting main self-study test. So this will ensure that you cover your newspaper as well, or their articles as well, or current affairs as well, while reading the standard books or the static books. And then the next test will be your revision test. So at the end of the every month there will be current affairs test, and at the starting of every month there will be a revision test that will cover the previous month topics. So test 5 will be of revision test. So this will ensure that you revise well, you do not forget the things that you have learnt, and you can retain the things, which is very important, because there are a lot of test series, but the problem there is that revision is not available. So we have also integrated this approach in our test series, that we will be providing you the revision tests as well. And then test 6 will be of art and culture, and this will comprise of an introduction to Indian art class 11th, and then living crafts and traditions of India chapter 9 and 10th, and your CCRT website, that is literary arts. So there will be, you can see that there is a time bound approach, and in similar manner then we will proceed to polity. And polity, we will be covering all the NCERTs like we have covered for history, and there will be also map based questions and polity questions of UPSC previous year papers, as well as your other NCRTs and other important things. So then after, as you can see that on 30 July there will be your current affair tests, and test 10 is your revision test, and this revision test will be of the previous month, that is of the July month, that of the topics that you have covered in July month. So in this manner we will proceed, and in similarly NCRT polity, so this is next test is of society, so there is no point of repeating the same things again and again. So you can see the detailed timetable in the description box, but I want to add that we are covering your NCRTs, we are covering your map based questions, we are covering past year papers. As you can see that for geography we are covering this geography questions of past year papers, and then we will also be taking your main self study test. So we are putting in lot of efforts, so certainly we are committed to it, and we will be putting our efforts. The effort is required from you people. The determination which is much needed is required from you people. And once we cover these NCRTs, we will be then by test 22, that is by 30 October 2019, we will have covered your entire NCRTs. And test 23 will be your kind of a revision test of whole syllabus that you have covered previously, or that comprises your NCRTs, your Da Hindu, PIB. So you can see that revision test is not just taken at the starting of the month, revision test is also there in the middle of the entire test series. So you can see there are 45 tests, so at 23rd the test comes your revision test, and then thereafter there will be 22 tests, and 22 tests, as I have told you, then we will start your standard books, and these standard books will include your Tamil Nadu history textbook, and of class 11, then important websites there, for example for art and culture there are CCRT websites, and then from modern India there will be a brief history of modern India by Rajiv Vahir. And similarly we will be covering your current affairs at the end of the every month, and at the beginning of the every month we will be taking your revision test. And similar manner we will cover the standard books for your polity as well, and then you will be covering for geography also. So for geography, as you know that there is a standard book, that is G.C. Leong, and then comes in for environment there is Shankar IAS. So in this way you will be covering your entire syllabus. So this is you can see this in this manner. So there will be revision tests, and also, and then when once we cover your entire syllabus, and here you can see we will be also covering the economic survey, and lastly then there will be full length tests. So there will be proper 6 tests that will be your full length tests, and by 15 May you will be free from our side. So obviously the possibility of the UPSC 2020 prelims is possible that it can be conducted at the end of the May month or at the beginning of the June month. So we are assuming both these possibilities, and you will be free from our side by 15 May 2020, but that doesn't mean that you will not be able to contact us after this. You will be able to contact us. We will continuously maintain the contact with you people, and we will continue motivating you, and will certainly help you if you, in case you needed us even after 15 May. So this is a, we can say that if you are joining us, then we are promising you a long-term relationship with you. So we will be there for you as long as you are preparing for UPSC. So we will be there, so we will not leave you. So this is the detailed timetable. So certainly friends, as we are putting in lot of effort, so certainly there will be a fee structure, because without fee structure we can't remain motivated to help you people. So certainly we have kept the fee as minimum as possible, but certainly we have to keep the fee at a level that we can sustain ourselves as well as our team also. So fee is basically 499 for prelims tests, and then for mains tests it is 14999. But in case you join us for both the test series, that is for prelims as well as mains, then you can get this entire test series in just 15999. So if in case you join us for both prelims and mains, then you will be getting a discount of rupees 4000. So entire test series will be available to you in 15999. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you like this initiative, if you want to enroll to this initiative, then you can contact us at this number, that is 8968426481, and you can also mail us to this email ID. And this is our YouTube channel, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. So in case if you are willing to join us, if you are committed to clear your exam, if you are willing that you want to have an edge over other candidates, then do ensure that you join us. We will certainly help you in achieving your dream. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a nice day.